All right, guys. Just felt like making a little video on glass, on cutting a piece of glass, and kind of got the idea from when I was going back and forth with Savage No More. So, God, I wish I had better lighting. But anyway, yeah, that ain't gonna work. Yeah, whatever. So, this is my old toolbox. It's an old Kennedy box. And what's cool about it is, when this box is closed, and you gotta work on a window, say, like that. And you put the box on the ground, like that. And you stand on it. And do your work, you know. Take the glass out, blah, 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 blah. Cut it, put it back in. That's what they were built for. So you can get into, like, a first-story glass window. Without your ladder. This box weighs a ton. So anyway, back to the box. We'll get the basics out. I'll show you what all this stuff is. It's pretty cool. I just got a lot of stuff in here I don't use that much anymore. I used to do wood sash windows with the putty and you brush the putty set after you take your putty knife and you'd 45 the putty in to hold the glass in. Had a point gun, you shoot points in to hold the glass into the wood and, you know, all that kind of neat stuff. There's a plexiglass cutter. It's an old Fletcher. I've had this for about 20-something years. And you can score plexiglass, even Lexan. You score it about 5-7 times and snap it. And I actually still use it sometimes when I have to cut a piece of plexiglass. This is an old Fletcher glass cutter. You make your cut, and if you've got little pieces, you can break them off with these little teeth. Break little pieces of glass off if you need. And that weighted ball on the end of the glass cutter, you tap from underneath to split the glass. So, I'll show you all that real quick right now. What else do I got in here? And the brakes. If you're taking off a sliver of glass, you can use these brakes. But, let's see. Let's see if I set the camera like this, if you guys can see what I'm doing. That's the glass right there. Take your glass cutter. I'll do a piece right in here. Pick it up, or if it's on the edge of the table, and you snap from underneath. So you twist it. Voila. I'll try to do that one-handed. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to do a wavy line in the glass. I'm trying to look through the camera. You just want to score it. You don't want to scratch it. See? I just did a wavy line. I'll take these cut runners and they put pressure from underneath. Magic. Did you see how it ran like that? Boom. Look at that. There's my wavy line. Simple as that. Now if I want to just do a straight, you know, take a piece off, I'll just see, it's got a carbide wheel. It's oil filled. This was my newer cutter back in the 80s. Replaceable head. It's oil filled. It's got a wick in it, so it always pumps oil onto the wheel. So you always get a nice clean cut. You just want to score it, just like that. Nice. I can't see what I'm doing. Shouldn't run it off like that, but take your breakers, line up the, just like a gun sight, line it up, squeeze the handle, see it going, boink, just like that, you know, and you could do it by hand too. I think, whoa, what am I doing? If I set the camera right there, so I can take this piece of glass right here. Cut it right down the middle.
pick it up like this. I hope you guys can see it. And you just want to, underneath is where you want to break. You can tap it, get it started like that. And you just take it and you twist down. Boom, see that? Just like that. I could even split this one. This is just regular window glass thickness. Now split that. Boom. Just like that. Split it. Now. And these are breaks too, you know, you can grab the edge of a piece of glass. I'm trying to figure out a spot. Show you. You can grab the edge of a piece of glass and kind of offset, so when you put the pressure on it, it breaks from underneath. These are real old. These are my grandfather's, probably from the 50s or 60s. I still get them, maybe even longer. Him and my great grandfather started the company in the 20s. When my grandfather was a kid, he started in the 20s, and I started in the 80s. These are the cut runners that goes on top. The round part goes underneath the glass, so when you put the pressure, see, it snaps it down. Boom. Then, I still have my suction cup. So if I was setting like a big plate glass window, pump it up. Oh, this table got a curve in it. You pump it up until the pump is all the way in. Pick up your glass. As you can see, and to release it, which you always want to be careful if you're carrying glass, never carry glass with your thumb on the release, because you'll drop it and cut your leg off. But we used to set plate glass windows, like say you're walking over, it's nice to have a suction cup. You know, I'm just pretending now, this is a frame here. Set the glass into the frame, silicone, you put your beading back around, or if it's a plate glass window, you put your, you know, whatever kind of molding was around it, metal molding, screw-in, whatever it was. Nowadays, everything's safety glass, so you don't get killed, but this is just a regular piece of window glass I had sitting around from a job, cut-off piece. Press the release button. Releases the air, thing comes off. And that's pretty much it. I did that for, like, 15 years, and, It was fun. I learned a lot because it was all old school stuff, you know. So I could pretty much cut anything you want out of a piece of glass. I'd cut you a circle. I could drill a hole through it for you. Cut laminated safety, plate glass, you know, plexiglass, window glass, quarter inch mirror, half inch plate. I could do a high polish edge. We had a wet sander and a belt sander. I mean, you know, they have machines now that bevel the edge and polish and everything like that, but we used to do hand polish, you know, nice, beautiful, clear edge, go from 100 grit to, you know, like 600 grit, you know, until you got it, like, crystal clear again. And that was it. That's my Kennedy box. All my crap in there for glasswork. Old window parts, corners for screens. Top rivets on these are screen corners when I used to build little window screen frames and then rescreen them for people. Just a ton of crap in here. This is another tool that's used to break off pieces of quarter inch plate glass. When the clips would get in the way of when you set the plate glass in a storefront, so they would take this tool and break out little pieces wherever the clips were. And that was and then I had a clamp for my straight edge. And before I run out of time, this is a big wooden straight edge ruler clamped down onto like a 4x8 sheet of mirror. Run it, then you'd lay this stick right underneath the glass and snap it. If you had a, you know, if you needed like a 6 foot by 4 foot mirror or something like that. Anyway, guys, gonna run out of time. That's just something I did for a long time. Anyway, have a great day.